Let's be real. When you think about Godzilla, you think massive monsters, insane amounts of destruction and mayhem, and dudes in suits. While some casual viewers may find the suit awkward and goofy, super fans of Godzilla and classic monster movies of all kinds see the beauty that is in this special art. Goji is not only just a funny sounding word, Goji, but also the name given to each and every one of the Godzilla suits that have been made. To figure out more on these Goji suits, let's go all the way back to where it all began. Some of us dream about being in front of a camera, but probably not quite like this. Imagine studio lights everywhere, beaming down heat like a mini sun, reaching temperatures well over 100 degrees Fahrenheit. Small explosions are being activated all around you, and the set in which you are in has small buildings falling down all over the place. And you just so happen to be wearing a suit that weighs over 200 pounds and retains enough heat to boil your tea. Introducing a cinema legend, Haruo Nakajima. The very first Godzilla actor could only bear so much at once when wearing this monster of a costume, filming for short bursts filled with plenty of breaks. He would get multiple cramps from dehydration and carrying the weight, and had stated that every film he starred in, he would lose 20 pounds of weight throughout the whole shooting process. This didn't seem to bother Haruo, as he was very proud in his role, even going above what was asked of him, as he was known to help the suit making process by letting the design team shape and mold the suit to his body to make sure that the final product seen on screen looked as well as possible. Have you ever thought to yourself how Haruo and the other monster actors were able to see and breathe through the suit? The head was a hat of sorts that would have tiny holes poked into the suit's neck, giving just enough clear sight to be able to perform the scenes. The Godzilla dorsal fins have a purpose of making the creature look 10 times more awesome, but they also hide one massive issue with these suits. To get into the large costume, Haruo and the other actors would have to climb into a giant hole in the back, which was covered up by the fins. To create the iconic original Godzilla design, a sketch of Godzilla would be drawn on a piece of plywood to full scale of the costume. From there, the rest of the pieces to the puzzle would come into play. A wireframe was first established to work as a skeletal support for the suit, covered then by a skin-like fabric that was filled with foam to give the suit the feel of having body structure and a more real-like appearance. The outside layer of the suit seen in the film is created by combining a type of latex rubber that is rumored to have a consistency similar to that of concrete. This foam would be shaped and sculpted to give us the rough and rigid skin that we see on Godzilla. From here on out, the original Goji suit design was used to influence and guide every single adaptation that was to follow. Unfortunately for Toho and us fans of these timeless pieces of cinema history, these suits would rot very quickly, and in as little as 2 years, the suits were beyond use for filming. That means a new suit had to be made often as the Godzilla franchise started to grow more and more popular, with fans begging for more monster action. This opened the possibility for many ideas and representations of the King of the Monsters. Shodai Gaiakushu, King, Mosu, Daisenso, Masuko, Soshingeki, Megaro, 84, Bio, Baro, Rado, Mogi, Meyer, GMK, Kiryu, Final. As the years went on and as society changed, so did the design of Godzilla. Each new suit being developed to go off of the new personality of the monster. From nearly lovable to downright frightening, the decades gave us plenty of portrayals of this iconic monster design. But in each suit, the heart, blood, sweat, and tears of Haruo and the original team put in place all the way back at the beginning of Godzilla's now 65-year-long life still beats. And you can see the inspiration from this original design through all the Godzilla suits throughout the decades. Except maybe these next two Goji suits. The 98 Godzilla film that fans have come to call Zilla was mostly done in CG, But you may be a bit shocked to know that there was also plenty of Godzilla suits that were used when making this movie. The Babyzillas at times in the film were full-on dudes in suits. These actors were sent to Godzilla school where they learned how to walk and act like these newborn monsters. The final product ended up being some of the best and most lifelike shots in the entire movie, and possibly even in the entire Godzilla series. Sorry, Zilla haters. The adult Zilla was intended to have a few scenes where an actor would wear at least a partial suit, but the film's team decided to go the route of animatronics, creating a nearly 15,000-pound animatronic of Zilla's torso and head. Speaking of animatronics, the most recent live-action Godzilla film, Shin Godzilla, also used an animatronic for many close-ups on the monster. While animatronics may not be costumes, they certainly deliver a similar effect and should be equally mentioned. In today's film industry, CGI has taken its place as the go-to for creating mythical monsters and creatures. Every little detail can be tweaked and adjusted at any time behind some computer. Legendary's Godzilla film showcased an entirely CG Godzilla, and it looked really good for the most part. Practical effects have always been a part of this series, and it is a big reason why Toho refuses to give up on using live props or suits. So the next time you watch a Godzilla film, new or old, think about all the hard work that went into creating our favorite monster. By impressive CGI, outstanding animatronics, and maybe just a dude in a suit. If you like these history videos, make sure to like and subscribe. And if there's anything else in the Godzilla or Jurassic Park world that you want to know more about, comment down below. So long, residents. Jacob out.